Hello students, I am Ravina Vora from JHB Sardar Primary English School. Students, we have learnt closure property and commutative property. Now we will learn associative property and additive identity for integer. Associative property, it is for the addition of three integers. Now students, we have learned associative property for whole number. If we want to add any three numbers, so we can't add directly. For example, 1 plus 2 plus 3, then either we have to add first 1 and 2 or 2 or 3, means either I have to add 1 plus 2 is equal to 3 plus 3 is equal to 6, or 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, 5 plus 1, 6. We will learn associative property for integers. Here there are three integers, minus 1, minus 3 and 2. Now I want to add. So, minus 3 and 2 are grouped. So, minus 1 is as it is, and the addition of minus 3 and 2, that is minus 1. And again, the addition of minus 1 and minus 1, answer is minus 2. Now, see here. Here, minus 1 and minus 3 are grouped. And 2 is as it is. So first addition of minus 1 and minus 3, answer is minus 4. Now addition of minus 4 plus 2, answer is minus 2. So if we will change the grouping of numbers or integers, but answer is same. So we can say that minus 1 plus group of minus 3 plus 2 is equal to group of minus 1 plus 3 plus 2. Hence, we can say addition is associative for integers. If A, B and C are integers, in general, we can say A plus in bracket B plus C is equal to in bracket A plus B plus C. Now we will learn additive identity for integer. Now additive identity. You know, for whole number additive identity is 0. Now let's check for integer. Here minus 6 plus 0. Then we will get answer minus 6 only. Here also 0 plus minus 19, answer is minus 19. So when we add 0 to any integer, the answer is the same integer. Okay, so we can say 0 is an additive identity for integers. In general, we can say A plus 0 is equal to A is equal to 0 plus A. So students, in next video, we will learn about multiplication of integers. Thank you.